whenever we have new recruits in police and fire and new employees for the other organizations, they get trained up on autism.
If you don't mind, I'd like to take it one step further.
Yeah, please.
Because this is really exciting for Mesa, and it's setting us apart. It's elevating our brand to new and national audiences. We didn't just stop at autism. We are on this mission, a serious mission, to be the most accessible city in the United States.
True.
And we're developing that reputation rather quickly. So we've partnered with Wheel the World. It's sort of like a, it's sort of like a Tinder meets Expedia. You know, you go onto this booking platform that Wheel the World has, and it allows you to establish what your preferences are for travel. You could be a wheelchair user. You don't have to be. You could have some other disability. It allows you to set your preferences. These are the kinds of things that I'd like to do, and it ends up picking a city for you, and then it ends up helping you identify what things you will do in that city. But it comes with a verified seal.
Especially
for wheelchair users, this is a trusted source for them to go to book in a community and at specific hotels and go to specific restaurants and specific attractions that have received the Wheel of the World verified seal. We were the first city in the world to do that. We also partnered with the Sunflower Hidden Disability Program. We were the first city to do that in the nation. Philadelphia Airport had done it, but no city had done it. We were the first. So that is, you could wear a wristband or this lanyard that's, it's green lanyard and it's got yellow sunflowers on it.
Okay.
And it is for someone who self-identifies as having some form of hidden disability. It could be PTSD, it could be autism, could be a whole host of issues, but it's sort of an indication to the hospitality worker, wherever they're at. It could be a museum, could be at a restaurant, that, okay, this person may need a little extra time, a little extra care, a little extra kindness. And this is now spreading all throughout the world. It started at London Heathrow Airport. And again, the first one was Philadelphia in the United States, but we're the first city to do this through and through. But it's only as good as your hospitality community's awareness of what it is. So we're constantly having to train our hospitality staff about what this is. Because as you know, in our business, there's lots of turnover.
We're
constantly turning over in our business. So you're constantly having to train people to know what this is, what this program is all about, to recognize what that is, and to be proactive in your customer service. So that's terrific. We have a partnership with AIRA, A-I-R-A. So for those with low vision or who are blind, we've geofenced all of Mesa. You can be a resident or you could be a visitor. And if you are in Mesa's boundaries, you can connect to a virtual interpreter via your cell phone, unlimited minutes, and they'll help navigate you in the city. You could be at the airport, you could be in a hotel, at a restaurant. You could be at a restaurant and the lighting is low and you're by yourself and you connect with the digital interpreter. They'll read the menu for you. So it's just additional touch points, you know, for those with disabilities. Just providing them the service that they need. And we feel like we're the perfect place because Mesa has a big heart. Mesa's always had a heart for initiatives like this.